Hello, and welcome to our Arkell Academy training videos channel. In this training video, we will explain in detail with practical examples the shaft learning settings in the R-Cube monoblock integrated elevator control system. This training video is for informational purposes only and has been prepared for specialists who are experienced and certified in elevator services. It is the responsibility of the person performing the installation or maintenance to take the necessary measures against all accidents that may occur during installation. Before shaft learning, mechanical installations must be completed. Shaft learning process. Preparations. Before starting the shaft learning process, electrical connections between the inspection box and the R-Cube panel must be completed. In order for the FX Cube inspection card to operate with the system, after the connections are completed, a software update must be performed. In addition, it is recommended that pit inspection and safety circuit connections are made correctly. 817 down and 818 up pre-limit switches should be connected to the corresponding terminals in the inspection box, according to the diagram. Also, pre-limit magnets should be placed in suitable places in the shaft, according to the diagram. The recommended 817 and 818 magnet distances are as follows. If the car speed is 1 meter per second, 817 down pre-limit magnets are placed 180 centimeters above the bottom floor, and the 818 up pre-limit switch is placed 180 centimeters below the top floor. If the car speed is 1.6 meters per second, 817 is placed 240 centimeters above the bottom floor, and 818 is placed 240 centimeters below the top floor. ML1, ML2 magnetic switches must be connected in accordance with the diagram after being mounted on the car. When connecting the switches, the ML2 switch should be located above the ML1 switch. If the lift sense product is being used instead of the ML1, ML2 switches, the connection must be made according to the lift sense document. 30 centimeter stick magnets should be placed to the door zones. When placing the magnets, the car door threshold should be on the same level as the floor door threshold. In this case, it is recommended to place the 30 cm stick magnet with the center point aligned between the ML1 and ML2 switches. If the lift sense product is being used, the car threshold is aligned to the floor threshold as much as possible. The starting point of the 30 cm stick magnet is placed on the rail, so that it is aligned with the installation line on the lift sense product. After the magnets are placed, the accuracy of the ML1 and ML2 switch connections must be checked. For this, the position of the ML1 and ML2 signals should be checked via R-Cube while the elevator is moving in recall or inspection mode. When the elevator goes through the door zone magnet while going down, it should be observed from the ML1 ML2 status monitoring menu that they are displayed as ML1 Plus and ML2 Plus respectively. If the system will not use a shaft copying feature, the deceleration and stopping operations must be ensured through the 141 and 142 switches. For this, it's necessary to correctly arrange the magnets with the related magnet configuration diagram and select the shaft position system parameter from the menu as ML1 ML2 counter. If there are bridges in the safety circuit, appropriate safety circuit connections should be made according to the electrical diagram. K3 closing signal, K5 opening signal, which are door command signals, and door safety circuit connections should be made according to the diagram. If the installation is being performed according to the EN81-20 standard, the 868 pit inspection signal should be connected to the pit inspection hand terminal. If the installation is being performed according to the EN81-1 standard, no connection is necessary for the 868 signal. Car-top inspection hand terminal should be connected to the inspection box. Pit inspection signal 868, car-top inspection signal 869, and recall signal 870 should be checked from the R-Cube display. Shaft learning. After completing the motor tune process in R-Cube, the shaft learning process must be performed. Before shaft learning, it should be observed that the safety circuit and inspection signals are active. Shaft learning in R-Cube should be performed as follows. Press the Enter key to enter the menu. Go to 2, Basic Settings, and set the 2.2 operation mode as normal operation. Exit the menu and save the changes. Go to Shaft Learning with the right button in the home screen. Press the up and down buttons simultaneously to start the Shaft Learning process. When Shaft Learning is complete and the text Shaft Learning Successful, press Enter to save the values is displayed, press the Enter key to save the values. Shaft Learning process is successfully completed. After the Shaft Learning process, floor fine level tuning has to be performed. For more information, you can visit our website to review the user manuals. See you in our next RKL training video. Goodbye.